This is Amy from Amy's Crazy Creative Life, and it's that time of year again to start getting ready for December Daily. And I don't know if you all remember, but my book last year, I had used an old encyclopedia cover, and I actually have quite a few of these because I got them from my parents. They had them from like 1984 or something, so I just took the pages out, and I'm going to use them for albums throughout the years. And so this year I wanted to do something a little different. And I had this like super cool, like shiny, pretty, whatchamacallit tape. Duct tape. Yes. That I thought would be kind of cute to put on there. And let me get my album from last year. I didn't do that last year. Last year I just had the simple white spine and then the rub-ons that I put on there, and then I put fabric over that that I printed on. So I don't know. To be honest, I really don't know if I like it. we'll find out. I think I'm going to put some like silvery type rub-ons or something on the cover to kind of match with it. I think it might turn out cute. But anyways, last year when I did my video, I had some questions about how I put the rivets on and the binder mechanism. So here is the binder mechanism. And I ordered this online. This is actually a smaller binder, smaller height than a standard binder mechanism. And first thing that I did is I took out the side thingies. They were right here. They're the things that you push down if you want to open the binder. But the problem is that they stick out like this. And so it really limits the size of paper that you have in your albums. So all that I did is I took pliers and I just, and it came right off. So easy. So for now what I'm going to do is attach the binder mechanism to the album itself. And what I did first is I put it down and I measured to be honest, I eyeballed it. And then I put pencil marks here and up here. And then I used my fabulous long reach Big Bite, and I cut the little holes there, and so now I'm going to attach the rivets, and so I'm going with 5/32 rivets from Arrow, and I just used the aluminum. Obviously, you don't need steel if you're just making a scrapbook, and so I will be putting that on here shortly, and I'll have another video when I'm doing that so you can see how that works. See you soon. Bye.